what we see is that a lot of customers and companies are moving towards the cloud, but in many occasions, they have no understanding what they actually have in the cloud today. So I was talking to one of our enterprise architects the other day, and they basically had a request from the CIO to determine how many accounts and how many virtual machines they currently have in the cloud. And interestingly enough, they had no clue, and they basically had to send a developer out for 2 weeks to basically write some scanning routines and provide that simple answer to the CIO only 2 weeks later. Cloud native basically is a fairly new terminology. This describes a number of concepts that people are using when they move into the cloud. And basically it describes a paradigm shift on how you actually architecture and develop software. So it includes utilization of native cloud services, so packaged functionality that you can basically directly take from the cloud provider, and combines that with agile principles, as well as modern microservice architectures that basically decomposition the architecture into a number of services that can run independent in order to deliver on the promise in the cloud, which is fault tolerance and adaptive scaling. Almost all companies these days are basically part of a digital transformation where their business model is undergoing fairly radical changes to basically better employ digital technologies. And cloud native is one of the key drivers that allows you to basically re-architecture on how you deliver your services. And that's why cloud native is of such high importance to at least many of the customers that we talk to. Empirically, we see that most of our customers and most companies employ a multi-cloud strategy. It's probably between 80 and 90% of the companies that deal with more than one of the public cloud providers. And while many of them have a preferred vendor, they basically want to ensure that they're independent of a specific vendor. And hence, when it comes to strategy and how you basically create an overview and your governance processes, it's very important that you keep a multi-cloud strategy in mind, because that's basically what's happening in almost every large company. Key challenges around cloud native is that it's a fairly radical paradigm shift. So companies struggle with adopting some of the new paradigms around consequent utilization of cloud services and the shift over to microservice architectures. And the reason is that in part is an educational one. You need to train your people. In part, it's also a governance and compliance issue where companies don't have the infrastructure to actually understand, what do I have in the cloud? What is the security issues that come up? Who is actually responsible for what part of the cloud? So many of these questions need to be answered as part of that transition from traditional on-premise architectures over to a true native cloud approach. It's key for your cloud native roadmap that you have a full understanding what that means. So it has aspects of organizational change and transformations of the way that you actually develop and deploy software. But it's also of key importance that you don't forget about the infrastructure that allows you to guide and govern the processes. So questions around compliance and security and how to ensure that as part of your cloud transformation that actually happens is of key importance. I mean, that's an area where we at LeanIX provide very good solutions. So if you have a multi-cloud strategy and you are wondering how to govern and how to ensure compliance with that move into the cloud and how to understand who owns what in the cloud, and also you possibly need help with some of the security questions, then basically at LeanIX we have very good solutions with our cloud native suite, which is comprised of cloud intelligence and microservice intelligence.